Hello to you from Art Market Gallery, the Israeli branch of Bruno Art Group. As we promised, we're trying to give you every week a short lecture about some interesting facts in art. This week we are going to talk about the Dada movement and the Israeli artist Marcel Yanko, who was one of the founders of that movement. So Yanko said that Dada and announced that it is a must to destroy the past in order to create a future. Of course, he meant about past and future in art. The Dada is so the abstract art as the future of art. Today, it's obvious for everyone that there is abstract art, but we are talking about 100 years ago, 1916, when many artists painted for their patrons portraits of them, their families, or they painted nice landscapes for the walls, and abstract art was almost not existed. Marcel Yanko was born in 1895 in Romania to a well-to-do family. His father was a merchant and his mother was a musician, and probably his genes for art came from her, his loves and his talent. Although his father did not want him to study art, but with the support of his mother, he already in 1910, being 15 years old, he started taking lessons with a Romanian famous artist, Iosif Iser, and was very talented. At the age of 16, Yanko found himself at an exhibition by Van Gogh. Van Gogh was a post-impressionist which painted landscape. But Yanko noticed a very interesting thing in Van Gogh paintings. Although he painted a landscape, in the example of the picture that you see here, the grass is red. Again, something that we would not notice these days, but then it was strange. So Yanko already saw in Van Gogh art going out of boundaries, and he considered him one of the first modern artists. In 1912, while Yanko is in high school, alongside with his friend Tristan Tzara, already published an art and culture magazine, The Symbol, with the aim to rebel against society. Those days he also already exhibited in art salons in Bucharest, Romania. So, his father's pressure influenced him, and in 1915, Yanko, together, by the way, with his friend Tzara, went to Zurich to study architecture in Switzerland, in Zurich, because, as we know, every Jewish father wants his kids to have a real profession. So we went to study architecture. In 1916, they saw an ad published by a guy named Hugo Ball that announced about an opening of a Cabaret Voltaire. And Hugo Ball asked for artists, musicians, writers, poets to join him in a social and a cabaret. And Yanko and Tzara joined and became the leaders of what will happen in this cabaret, the establishment of the Dada movement. So we are talking about the Dada movement as an art movement, but it was not only art. It was different literature, different poetry, different theater, and all those guys that time wanted to break the rules, wanted to break, as Yanko said, destroy the past in order to have a a new future in art. So what is destroying the past in art, in paintings, is not painting realistic anymore, but crazy abstracts. And destroying the art in theater is to come up to the stage and just talk nonsense. Talking nonsense and being dressed in ridiculous costumes, which, by the way, Janko was one of the ones that designed them, but speaking nonsense to a point that the crowd will throw vegetables at you and coins, but this is what they wanted. They wanted to destroy the old theater to have the ground ready for the new theater, new poets, and again, new poets, as they declared then, is just coming to the stage and say words that has no meaning and no connection one to the other. Back to art, those days, the Dada days, Janko's art, basically was realistic, but of course with a cubic style, like we can see in the slide above me, and of course abstract. Unfortunately, many of those paintings disappeared within the time, the World War II. We don't have in our collection art from that time, but I will show you a couple of samples in this small booklet. These are paintings from the Dada's time, 1917 till 1920. As you can see, abstracts and a lot of use in collages and relief. Again, collages, we think, oh, what's so unique about it? But remember, we're talking 100 years ago when it was not so common, if at all. Well, end of First World War kind of was the end of the Dada movement, and in 1922, Tristan Tzara, which was maybe the leader of the movement, said that there's no point for Dada anymore, and they kind of stopped operating. But as I'll show you later, we may think that Dada is still relevant today. What happened is the participants of the movement went back to their home countries and started kind of small Dada movement in their places, or act according to Dada's ideas. For example, Jean Arp was the representative of Dada in Paris, Marcel Duchamp in New York, and so on. Janko went back to Romania after completing his studying in architecture and becoming an architect in Romania, and followed Dada rules or Dada ideas in the following way. He declared that the time that Tata was disruptive ended, and now Dada needs to be constructive. And now how he applied it in his architecture. He said, okay, now we need to build the future. In architecture, Janko said the future should be in clean, basic homes with a lot of space, with a lot of light. The homes should be serving the inhabitants. They should not be decorated from the outside. It's not important. And this is the way that he followed the Dada ideas of building the new future, in this case in architecture. He called it constructive Dadaism. Janko first visited Israel in 1938 and went back to Romania, where he succeeded very much as an architect, as an artist. He had many, many shows in galleries, museums. But he felt the Nazism coming into Romania. He felt Europe is shaking, and in 1941 he immigrated to Israel. Also because in his vision he saw Israel as a new land, a new opportunity, and when he came to Israel he said, let's see what I want to, how I will affect the new place, this new country. His painting from that time changed, of course, like other artists that came from Europe, and we'll talk about it, you know, in a second. In Europe, with the dark sky, his paintings were brown, gray, and in Israel, of course, the bright skies brought yellow, red, and blue to his paintings. Still, as we see in this slide of the painting of Tiberias, even when he paints the landscapes, it was in his Dada style, in the Cubist style, a very special style, but the color palette changed. In 1948, Yanko found himself again involved in the establishment of a new art movement, New Horizons, this time in Israel, together with other artists that came from abroad, mainly from Europe. They established this movement that put the ground for what we know today as the Israeli art. Other leaders of the group were Streichmann, Zaritsky, that also came from Europe, from these dark skies into the bright skies of Israel, and their entire color palette changed to reflect the bright colors of Israel. And we consider New Horizons to be the first movement, art movement, which is purely Israeli art. If we ask what is Israeli art, New Horizons was the first movement that was Israeli, pure Israeli art. Artists came from abroad, Europe, Asia, Africa, but now there was a movement, an Israeli art movement, which also was an alternative to the old Israeli Artistic and Sculptural Association, on those days was a small close clique. He also had to make a living, so even in Israel in the 40s, he worked as an architect, first under the British mandate and then for the Israeli government and the city of Tel Aviv. And he was dominated to be in charge of the Israeli parks. So he traveled a lot in the country, and on one of those trips he discovered a place, a deserted Arab village, Hen Hud, on the Mount Carmel. And once again in his life, he is initiating a huge project, which is the village Hen Hod, artistic village Hen Hod, which exists still today. And once that those of you that were not there, I recommend a lot after this situation to go and visit it. He created a silkscreen workshop, artistic workshops, galleries, and which many of those places exist still today. Plus, in 1983, with the help of friends, he established the Dada Museum in Hen Hod, also a must-see location. There you can see quite a few works from the Dada time, the 1970 to 1920. Again, recommend to visit. In our collection, we have his latest work. Latest, we are talking about 1950s, 1960s. Of course, abstract. If we look at this painting, for example, it's titled Birkat Kohanim in Hebrew, in English, Priest Blessings. Abstract, the people, and later we'll see animals are distracted in an abstract way that you cannot recognize. But when I tell you, at least to the Israeli to the Israelis when we speak about Birkat Kohanim. Everyone can see here the in his imagination the Kohen blessing. Another typical motive in Yankos are the animals. Here, kind of almost realistic. See, we see the goat, which is, we see many of them in Yankos art. And here, we can see another subject that Yanko liked a lot, the Don Quixote. Of course, it's easy to see the horse here, but of course it's not a realistic horse, but in Yanko drawing. Here we have a painting, a drawing from the 1930s of Romanian soldiers. Yanko describes with very, very little lines the people in his unique way. And here a piece from 1948 of Shimshon HaGibor. Another series that he did in the 60s was Imaginary Animals. We have it in our collection, the piece that we have that you see in the slide, but it's not here in the gallery. Once again, these are animals in Yanko's vision. After telling you, I'm sure that everyone can identify an animal here that he likes. You cannot describe, there are no names, but it's easy to relate to these nice, funny animals. Well, on a personal aspect, Marcel Yanko was a good friend of my father, Mr. Bruno, which was also born in Romania. They knew each other from those days. He was represented with our group or gallery since the 1960s till he passed away in 1984. I'm holding here the invitation which Yanko himself designed in 1982 to his last exhibition before he passed away. So his last exhibition was in my father's gallery. So I had the privilege to know him since I was a kid. We are the Israelis, we are very proud of our iTech, we are very proud of since many years ago, companies like ICQ, and nowadays Wix, and Waze, and Mobilize, and many others. I think that we can be also proud of our artists. Last week we talked about Yaakov Agam, that founded in 1953 the Kinetic Art Movement. Today we spoke about Marcel Yanko, who was the founder of Dada. Dada, a movement that set the ground to many art movements. Marcel Duchamp was a Dadaist, went back to the state, developed this idea of ready-made, which comes from the ideas of Dada, of their using those ready things to create the mask and the costumes for the theaters. And even the pop art of Warhol started from the Dada ideas. So, we are here for any questions, and of course everything is on the web for you. We wish you to stay healthy and hope that we can meet each other in reality in one of our galleries. And till then, we'll try to keep on with our short lectures, and I thank you very much for listening. Stay safe.